Hello students of class 6, so today I am going to start new chapter, that is algebraic equation. Okay, so already we have learned about algebraic expression in our last class. Okay, in last chapter already we learned about algebraic expression. In that case we have studied about variables, constant. If we want to write a real life situation, okay, real life situation where suppose cost of one item is not given and we have to form an expression using that situation, then we can easily use algebraic expression. In that case we have to use variable, which the quantity which is not given, we have to use variable for that. And if there is any constant number which is given, we have to take it as it is. Okay, so that means as it is we have to take that number. Okay, constant means you already know that we have to take the same number only. So here also we have to form algebraic equation. So what is the difference between algebraic expression and algebraic equation? So see students, here there is an example. Suppose x plus 3, okay, up to this if I write, then it is an algebraic expression. But if I write equal to and I assign one number, any number, it may be any number, any, you can say any negative number or any positive number or zero. Okay, so this is called algebraic equation. So what is the meaning of equation? See here, in the word equation the word is there, equate. The meaning of equate is we are equalizing. Okay, we are equalizing the expression x plus 3 and we are assigning a value to x plus 3. Okay, so here we are writing equal symbol. So the meaning of equate is simply in mathematically we have to write equal to symbol. Okay, so here is the definition of algebraic expression. An equation is a mathematical statement equating two quantities. That means we have to equalize two quantities. So here this quantity is one quantity and the other quantity is this one. So here we are equating. Equating means we are equalizing. We are placing equal to symbol between the two quantities. Okay. So here it is written, the expression on either side, the equal to sign, are called members of the equation. That means these are called members. Okay. This is an algebraic equation and these are called the members. So x plus 3 and 0 are the members of this equation. Similarly here y plus 2 and 0 are the members of this algebraic equation, y plus 2 equal to 0. So this is also an algebraic equation where there are two members, one is in this side and the other is in this side. So what these sides are called, see, this is to your left hand side. When you write in the copy, then you will see that this part is at your left hand side. So we have to write here left hand side. This is left hand side. So left hand side, in short we can write LHS. Okay, similarly this part is to the right. Okay, this is to the right side of our hand. So we have to write right hand side, or in short we can write RHS. So these are the two members of an algebraic equation. So again see, this is an equation. Again x plus 3 is equal to 0. So we don't know the value of x. What is x? We don't know. This is an unknown. So here by using this equation we can easily find the value of x. So which value I have to assign into x so that this left hand side part is equal to the right hand side part. So the value which we have to assign to x is what? Minus 3. Because when we add minus 3 to plus 3, we will get what? 0. So x is equal to minus 3 is the what? Is the answer of this equation, or you can say the solution of this algebraic equation. Because when we are putting that value, we are getting this left hand side part is equal to the right hand side part. But if you put any other value, if you are not putting minus 3 and if you put any other value, then we will not get both side equal. Okay, so we should get the both side of the algebraic equation, the both side of the algebraic equation should be equal. Okay, so you have seen balance. Whenever you go to the market, you have seen balance in which the shopkeeper used to weigh the items, okay, which you are going to buy. So in that case you have seen the balance, and in case of balance you have to check one thing, that both sides should be same, both sides should be equal weights. That means it should be in a balanced condition. So when it should be in a balanced condition, when both side weight will be what? Equal. So here also, in case of equation, we have to equalize both side, that is left hand side and right hand side. So suppose if you want to add any number to one side of the equation, then you have to add the same number to the other side of the equation. For example, in the right hand side, if you want to add 2, then in the left hand side also you have to add 2. Similarly, if you want to subtract some number from any of the side, then the same number should be subtracted from the other side also. Okay, so that these are the some rules of algebraic expression. Okay, for when we solve the equation, then we have to follow these rules. Okay, so one is for addition, next is for subtraction, third one is for multiplication. That is, whenever we multiply any number to any side of the equation, then the same number should be multiplied to the other side. Similarly, if you want to divide by any number other than 0, okay, we cannot divide by 0 because it will be a meaningless quantity. You know that already, we have learned these things. So whenever we want to divide by any number to any side of the equation other than 0, then with the same number you have to divide with the divide to the other side also. Okay, so these are the four rules, and the four rules are for addition, subtraction, multiplication and division respectively. Okay, so you can also learn from page number 126, all the rules are given, and there is a weight machine, or you can say a balance is shown here. So you can see here the weight in left hand side and right hand side part should be equal, so that this middle one arrow should be exactly at 90 degree angle, or you can say exactly upward, okay, in upward direction. It should not be like tilted, it should not be like this one or this one, okay. It should not be in tilted position, the middle arrow, okay, that should be in straight upward position, okay. So in that case only the both side will be in a balanced condition, means both sides are equal, okay. So the next topic is solving an equation. So if we are studying equation, so what is the main application behind it, and why we are studying an equation? So by studying an equation, we can easily simplify that equation and we can find the value of the unknown. Okay, suppose you are given a condition that if you add 2 to your age, then the age will become 13 years. Okay, if you add 2 to your age, then the age will become 13 years. So what will be your age? Suppose if I give you this example, then what will be your age? Your age will be how much? Yes, 11. Because when we add 11 to 2, we will get 13. But see, 11, the age of your that is 11 age, that is not given condition. What are the given condition then? The given condition is when you are adding 2 to your age, you will get 13. So with the help of this condition, we can easily make an equation. So how to make an equation? See, your age is x and you are adding 2 to it. Why we are taking it as x? Because we don't know what is the age, what is your age, okay, it is not given in the question. All it is given that you have to add 2 to your h. So let it be, let your h be x or let your h be y or z. You can take any variable like we have discussed in the last chapter also. So by adding these two quantities we will get 13. So how to write 13? We can write 13 like this, but in between them what symbol we have to write? We are getting 13, that means we have to write equal to. That means if we add 2 to your if you add 2 to your h, then you will get 13. So you will get means what? We have to place equal to symbol. So that means x plus 2 is equal to 13. So how to find the solution and what is called solution? Solution, here the meaning of solution is x. So x is called the solution because here 2, we know 2 means 1, 2, we can count. 13 also we can count. But what is the value of x? We don't know. So this is called the solution. X is called the solution of the equation. Or one another name of it is root. Okay, so this things you are learning new. Okay, so solution or root, both are what? They both are same. So x is also called the root of this equation. Root and solution are same thing. So how to find the solution? How I can find the value of x? So there is a method that is called trial and error method. So by using that method we can easily find the value of x. So what is trial and error method? See, solving an equation by trial and error method. So by trial and error method. Trial means we have to try and error means mistake. Okay, so we will try many values. We will put many values in place of x and we will see that when left hand side equal to right hand side. Okay, so suppose first of all, you know that your age will not be is equal to a negative quantity and your age will not be equal to 0. So what will be the possible age? So possible age starts from 1. So we have to write, let first of all x is equal to 1. So we have to put first of all 1 in place of x. So 1 plus 2 is equal to 13. So we have to solve. See, 3 is equal to 13. But 3 is not equal to 13. So we have to put this symbol. The meaning of this symbol is not equal. Similarly, like this, we have to put 2 in place of x. So 2 plus 2 is equal to 13. This is also not true because 4 is not equal to 13. Okay. The symbol, the meaning, the how to read this symbol, this is not equal to. Okay. This symbol is not equal to. Similarly, like this, you have to put many values. Let x is equal to 3, let x is equal to 4. Finally, I will put let x is equal to like this only 10, then 11. So next I will put 11. So after putting 11, what will happen? 11 plus 2 is equal to 13. So see, we'll get 13 is equal to 13. That means this is the solution because here we are getting the left hand side equal to right hand side. But in all other cases, see, left hand side is not equal to right hand side. So when it becomes equal, when we are putting x is equal to 11, that means what will be our conclusion? Therefore, x is equal to 11 is the solution, or you can say root of the given. That means what was our given equation? This was our given equation, so we have to write given equation. Okay. Next, finally, you can write, so our age will be what? Our age is what? 11 years. Okay. So you have to show all the process. Just see, I have written directly because it will take time. That's why I have written directly. So but you, when you are doing any question, you have to you have to write all the possibilities, all the numbers. Okay. So finally you will get the solution. So why it is called trial and error? Because we are trying one value, we are getting error, then again we are trying another value, then we are getting again error. So that's why it is called trial and error method. Okay, so let us do the next exercise.